shows just one change from last season's successful lineup. At number eight, new signing Gary Lineker replaces the since-departed Andy Gray. But Adrian Heath is fit again. He's among the substitutes, as is their new goalkeeper from Rotherham, Bobby Mims. Manchester United have also signed a new keeper, so Gary Bailey now has to contend with the challenge of Chris Turner from Sunderland. The team shows two changes from the cup final. Graham Hogg and Mike Duxbury replace Kevin Moran and Gordon Strachan, who are both injured. United resisted the Italian interest in Norman Whiteside this summer, and another of their cup final heroes, Frank Stapleton, turned down the chance to move to French champions Bordeaux. Had he gone, United were hoping to sign Gary Lineker before Everton took him from Leicester. As it is, Lineker's £800,000 transfer fee has been of particular interest to the Prime Minister, who remains unconvinced about football's plea of poverty. And on a financial note, the FA have told me that well over £200,000 will go directly to charity out of today's gate receipts. Our referees are still involved in Europe. Joe Worrell, one of six FIFA men who will be officiating in the first round. Just in the background there, Remy Moses, who hasn't played since last February, but is in fact among the Manchester United substitutes this afternoon. Friendly atmosphere down there. That's John Bailey of Everton talking to the Manchester United manager, Ron Atkinson. Manchester United kick off in the black shorts, playing from left to right. Wembley had to carry out some hurried surgery on the pitch after the Live Aid concert here, and if there are one or two marks, it's possibly also due to the fact that before this match, the England under 16 team, drawn from the FA's School of Excellence at Lillishaw, defeated Yugoslavia 3-2 in a very entertaining game after the England boys were 2-0 down. First, went under Robson's legs there, and Lineker got a shot in. Now this is not going to please the crowd. Defenders pushing up in a match which really should be something of an exhibition. We don't want too much use of the offside trap if the game is going to win back some appeal. Stevens is coming through from right back, and it was cleared by Hogg again. Run on to Trevor Stephen and hooked back, and Lineker's in there. Well, Lineker close to opening his Everton account with a very good ball from Trevor Stephen. Actually, Lineker has already been on target in a couple of the pre-season games, and he got up well there to the cross, headed over the bar. Trying to get Lineker in behind the defence. He's making several runs on the blind side and hoping to catch the Manchester United markers out. Peter Reid, Van den Hau. Decent cross, Lineker. Manchester United were all over the place there. It's good play by the left back, Pat Vandenhout. A lovely deep cross. Lineker knocked it back beyond Bailey, but help was on hand. Corner. Bailey comes. He's sharp. This is Gidman. Stephen offside against Sharp. Done by Lineker, combining with Bracewell, then with Sharp. Stephen out on the right, a bit hurried. Gidman on Sheedy. Oh, McGrath, a bit elaborate. This is Sheedy and Stephen. Has played with so much composure in the cup final and again today, but there in defence he just tried to be a little bit too clever. Kevin Sheedy whipped the ball away, crossed low, and Trevor Stephen put Everton in front after 28 minutes. Bad luck McGrath, he was trying to play football but he got caught out. His frustration, Graham Hogg has been spoken to by the referee, but McGrath, who's got terrific potential as a ball-playing centre-back, does just take the odd risk. He did in the cup final, which led to Moran's tackle and sending off, actually, and he tried it on again there and got caught out. Oh, and there's Stephen again, and here's Bracewell. Bracewell intercepted, this is Sharp. Reed. Bracewell again. Bracewell, deflection on that. Robson ran in front of Bracewell as he shot, but there may have been an offside before that flagged, which is why the referee has now changed his signal. Hogg. Turn, looks for Stapleton, but two defenders are there, and Ratcliffe, one of the quickest around. Right side in on Bracewell, Hughes. Oh, Brian Watson's offside. Go in the first half. Everton 1, Manchester United 0. Olsen. This attack. This is McGrath making it six, but he's lost out to Sheedy again. And Peter Reid wasn't sure where the ball was for a moment, having made his run. And it gave Manchester United the chance to recover. And it's fallen well for Hughes. Sheedy's tackle. And now, onside. Oh, and it's sharp. McGrath went down, Sharp's through, and Lineker's up there. Offside! Offside, surely, when the ball went in the net, even if it wasn't a foul earlier when McGrath was pulled down. Now then, two reasons why Manchester United believe the goal shouldn't have been given. McGrath felt he was fouled when Sharp and Lineker went through, and when Sharp jabbed it to Lineker, he might well have been offside. It's still 1-0. Here's Stapleton. See why he had to make a tackle there, Sheedy, but he's committed a foul on Mark Hughes. This is Robson and this is Duxbury. Now Gidman. Motson puts it forward. Southall has had hardly anything to do in the first half. Will be quite glad of some action, I would imagine. He came there to meet Mike Duxbury. This is Hogg. Hughes was jumping right into Mountfield there. And the league champions Everton well worth their lead at half time. Frankly, the first half was a bit of an embarrassment for Manchester United, the cup holders. They hardly had a shot. Trevor Stephen, though, was the man that put Everton in front after 28 minutes, following an unfortunate mistake on Paul McGrath's part when he conceded possession in his own danger area to Kevin Sheedy. So at half time, Everton lead by 1-0. There's a subtle change in the laws this season as they affect the goalkeeper's collection and distribution of the ball. If in future the goalkeeper wants to pick up the ball again, having already released it from his hands, it must now be played by one of his defenders outside the penalty area rather than inside. If it's played by an attacker, it doesn't matter where it is, but he can no longer bring a defender right up to him and just tap the ball and get it back from a yard or so. The defender must play it outside the 18-yard area. So Everton start the second half. Manchester United will be hoping for better things. Notably their most famous son and now a director, Bobby Charlton, sitting with his wife Norma in the royal box there. Gary Stevens. Lineker closing in on Gary Bailey. And a late challenge by Kevin Ratcliffe. Duxbury. There's Sharp. That was a nice touch. Stephen looks for Lineker, who was running as the third man on the left. Bracewell sprinting up inside him. There are two the other way. And Bracewell forces a corner on Cobb. That was good, swift attacking football by Everton. Away, Sheedy back, Olsen the miss kick, making Robson work overtime again. This is Reid. Offside, but Stapleton who's been caught. Stapleton's got Olsen making a good run in the inside left position. He found him. Well, Olsen was blocked off a bit by Ratcliffe, but Stapleton set the play up. Just about Manchester United's best move of the match. Here's Whiteside. And now Gidman. Lineker. Off the heels of McGrath. A bit lucky there. Whiteside. Oh. Second time, but still only to Ratcliffe. And Sharp is up with Hogg, and here's Lineker, play on. Good advantage by Joe Worrell, the referee. Here's Trevor Stephen. Oh, and Bailey. Bit of use of the hands there, so it wouldn't have been a goal, but... again, Everton looking threatening. And a good advantage played by the referee when he could have stopped the game there for a... an earlier infringement. Offside. You've really got to look to the line every time Manchester United attack, because Everton are just pushing up with this back four and killing it off. But one can live in hope if you're a Manchester United fan, because they have proved in the past they can get players through. It often has to be a midfield player who makes that sort of successful break. Offside. Lineker following through with his shot. I think what Everton feel about the signing of Lineker is that he'll give them that bit of extra pace in getting in behind defences. And already we've seen signs of that. That was a foul by Ratcliffe on Hughes. Whiteside and Vandenhuis squared up to each other for a moment. The first signs of unpleasantness, and the referee wants Vandenhuis quickly because he has already spoken to him about a foul earlier. Here's Robson. Crowd this afternoon inside Wembley, 82,000. Hughes with the shot and well stopped. A smart turn, an instant drive by Mark Hughes, of which he's so eminently capable, but then so is Southall of that type of save. Sheedy. This is Bracewell. And here's Sharp. some of the Manchester United supporters in the 82,000 crowd. Checking his watch. Two substitutes allowed out of the five who've been named on each side. Everton still holding the balance of play, forcing the free kick. Mountfield. Well taken by Ratcliffe from Olsen. Offside against Mountfield now. He it was who had the header from a well-worked free kick. They changed the angle a bit by letting Van den Howe take it, not Sheedy. And Mountfield's header, on another day, might have been better placed. We've been playing for a quarter of an hour in the second half. And Everton still hold the lead. So the return of Remy Moses, who missed the last 3 months of the season with injury last time round, and comes on for Mike Duxbury. Good reception for him from the Manchester United fans. He'll go into the midfield, where Manchester United have often been second best so far this afternoon. McGrath's header, then Mountfield. Understandable that he should go on and shoot, although Brian Robson to his left wanted a square pass. The chance was so inviting, he was onside and he drove over. It was set up by Whiteside, and it was the first time that they've managed to puncture that square-lying Everton defence and give the man a clear run at goal. But it shows it can be done, as they proved in the cup final. Interesting that in the cup final Hughes put Whiteside through for the goal, and today it was the other way round, and there was a very different finish. Here's Hughes, Moses. Well, the presence there of Gidman in the outside right position gave Manchester United an extra attacker and forced a corner. Will take it. Stapleton. Here's Olsen again. Gidman. The ball bobbling a bit there in front of Gidman. Here's Hogg. Hughes going at them. McGrath held them off well. Motson, right side, didn't strike it properly. Better this from Manchester United, and their supporters appreciate the fact. right side to Stapleton. Hugh is making ground in the centre. Corner off Gary Stevens. McGrath is forward. Oh, Robson! And here's Olsen. Alderston! Oh, twice Southall's defenders helped. He missed it completely the first time. And they stopped Robson, and then Orbiston shot. Southall got to that, but there was a man on the line in case. And Manchester United have come close to the equaliser, but couldn't quite force it in. White side, this is a much better performance now from the FA Cup holders. There was a foul by Van den Howe. Referee played a good advantage again because United had possession. But they didn't get a free kick for that one by Sheedy. And play has gone on. Stephen. McGrath. Offside. Well, if Remy Moses got a big welcome back, so too, I'm sure, will Adrian Heath for Everton, out since last December when he was injured against Sheffield Wednesday, on crutches for a long time. He has replaced the new signing, Gary Lineker. And he'll be delighted to get back before a big crowd. He's figured in one or two of Everton's pre-season games and scored, Adrian Heath. It's been a long time out for him. 14 minutes for him to play today. Stevens offside against Bracewell this time. Sheedy this time. Oh, and Heath had a chance. Scores. Gary Bailey lost it. And quite a return for Adrian Heath. With 8 minutes to go, he makes it 2-0 to Everton. And originally from a good cross by Pat Van den Howe, who curled the ball in and Gary Bailey didn't gather. And Adrian Heath forced it slowly over the line. He'd only been on the field for about 6 minutes. And his goal may well mean that Everton keep the charity shield. They're two up now. Motson again. Orbiston. It's going to fall for Brian Robson to lob it back in. But there could be a break on for Everton. No, there won't be, because McGrath has intercepted. Whiteside. And Bracewell finds Roode, and there could be a break on now. Sharp. Oh, he did well there, Graham Sharp, but so did the defender, Graham Hogg. Side Stapleton and Olsen tries to find Stapleton, but Bracewell saw the danger, and a late substitution by Everton. Vandenhout appears to be injured, and John Bailey is coming on. Less than a couple of minutes to go. This is Moses. Whiteside's in there. So was Mountfield. The referee got an inadvertent touch. Hughes. Everton break here with four against four. Peter Reid leading the charge. Sheedy's through the middle, one either side. He's found Sharp. Bailey gets a touch. And also a corner. In the 6-yard box. And this time Bailey beats Mountfield to it. Here's Heath. Good cross. Diving header away by Stapleton. Stevens. Sharp at the far side, and Sheed is waiting for the chance, but it wasn't called back to him by Trevor Stephen, who had a go himself. Stoppage time. Trophy in about 15 months for the modern Everton. They retain the charity shield with a 2-0 victory over the side who beat them here in the FA Cup final last May. A goal in each half. The first by Trevor Stephen on 28 minutes, and then after Manchester United had had a good spell halfway through the second half but failed to equalise, Adrian Heath got the second with 8 minutes to go shortly after coming on as substitute. Howard Kendall and Everton will feel that they've started the new season very much in the manner that they finished the last, when they won the Championship and the European Cup Winners' Cup. So a familiar journey now for Kevin Ratcliffe, the captain of Everton and Wales, as he goes forward to receive that shield which is glinting in the afternoon sunlight. being presented by Mr. John Fleming, the chairman and managing director of Vauxhall Motors. That's the first trophy of the 1980s.